Hey everybody, ChristopherOdd here. Welcome back to Enemy Within. The only objective that we have left is to use the ethereal device. So let's get in here and do that. Once the ethereal device is triggered, all forward progress will be stopped. Any current research or foundry projects will not be completed. Any injured soldiers in the infirmary will not be healed. Commander, are you sure you wish to proceed? Yes, let's do this. The only person that can do it is Annette Durand, and she's fully leveled up psionic now, so pretty excited.
With each of our major victories, we have encountered incrementally more powerful aliens. After the first alien craft was shot down, they began a campaign of terror. The alien forces were led by a sectoid commander, a powerful psionic creature. Upon capturing the hyperwave beacon, we detected a cloaked ship carrying a being of incredible psionic power. Having captured the device it sacrificed itself to protect, an immense alien ship has now appeared within our atmosphere. We can only assume that a being of even greater psionic power is on board this vessel. We have already pushed human evolution so far, and I fear where the next step will take us. But our enemy leaves us with no other choice. A new type of weapon is required.
At long last, you have succeeded where we have failed.
Here we go. Assault the temple ship. Let's do this. Now, to decide who's coming out, we know that our two mechs are coming out. And I know people are like, get Waldo off the squad. And I totally agree with you, but she's here. And this is actually, so my first playthrough of Enemy Within has really been a lot of learnings, especially how to use the mechs, experimenting with different abilities. My playstyle's changed pretty drastically from XCOM Enemy Unknown, which is cool. And so that being said, I am going to bring out our two mechs. Durand is obviously coming. She is going to be our support. I don't know if I want to wear the Psy armor or if I want her to have... Oh, she has to wear it. Unable to volunteer. Unavailable to volunteer. Oh, okay. So she does have to wear Psy armor. Cool. Let's clear out everybody else and let's decide who we're going to bring. So Boom Boom 100% is coming. Now, do I want her to wear the Chitin plating? What else could she wear or use? I'm trying to think of what would be the most beneficial. We're going to see Thin Men at some point, but I don't know if that's worth... I don't know if that's worth going to Respirator for, taking reduced... No, I don't think it is, because we can easily heal that off. We could go Alien Grenade. Actually, I'm pretty happy with the Chitin plating. Let's keep her like that. And for some reason, I've completely forgotten to switch her back to the heavy greens. Where is it? We changed up the color a little bit. There we go. Makes much more sense. Durand, you are kind of confusing me a bit. That's supposed to be white. But maybe I can switch this up a bit to get more white. It's all the pants are so dark. I guess that'll work. Okay, cool. Next. Ragery. Yes, you are definitely coming. You've got the alloy cannon, plasma pistol. I like having the scope. I like the Chitin plating. I think this is okay. And then last but not least, I think we have to bring Gussie. Gussie's been a big major component here. That being said, another heavy is very, very tempting to bring. Very tempting. You know what? There could be some passages here in this final area where having her squad site ability could be pretty major. We're gonna make items available. Plasma sniper, plasma pistol. Let's go Chitin plating. And what else? Oh, the scope, obviously. All right, this is a squad we're gonna roll out with. I'm happy with this. I would love to have more explosives, but we do have a bunch of grenades from these two. I think this is gonna be okay. Let's do this.
Touching down.
Bradford has nothing to say to me. That's too bad. Okay, force entry to the temple ship's bridge. The volunteer must survive. This is probably going to be a long mission. Wish me luck.
You hear our voice, new one. Now listen well. Long have we watched and waited. So many promising subjects. So many failed efforts. And now, after untold trials, the new one emerges. Face the rigors of our collective, an enduring physical form paired with an equally adept mental capacity, the rarest of traits finally within our grasp.
So what's really cool about these this temple base mission thing is that, okay, so you notice here that we've got a sectoid, albeit it is a sectoid commander. Basically, what happens is, as you progress through here, you encounter all of the enemies kind of in the same progression that you encountered them in the game. It's really kind of a cool thing to see. Now, we do have a new ability here that you get on the last mission with Annette called Rift. And what this does, in case you're not sure, I'll just show you. Devastate an area with a storm of psi energy. The Rift does more damage against targets with low will and reduced damage against targets with high will. It's a 4-turn cooldown, but it does a lot of damage to a pretty large area. We also do have the telekinetic field, which, it looks like it just goes out in a way around us. It's like plus 40 defense, I believe. This is the one, yeah, plus 40 defense to both allies and enemies within the field. Oh, interesting. Interesting. Lasts through the enemy turn. Okay, plus 40 defense is pretty huge. So we'll have to see how we're going to use that to the best of our abilities. I would like to just dash into some type of heavy cover here. This is heavy cover. Let's take this. All right, we found two more.
Headed there now.
You know more about this than I do.
She's concealed as well. And then we're just gonna kind of sneak up on these guys.
I'm on the move. Eyes peeled.
Gut gemacht.
Moving to Overwatch.
The new one faces the earliest effort of the ethereal ones. The first failure. Though possessed of a certain brilliance, they were marred by their cowardice and frailty, which made them cruel and ultimately useless.
So they're talking about how the sectoids were like total shit, basically. I'm going to go for a critical here. It's 100%, probably because I'm invisible. 10 damage, and then maybe I can just take him out completely. That would be great. Oh, one away.
ET's got a party line.
Whoa, he pieced right out. Okay. Now, we do have these two to deal with. What I could do... I could just mind fray one. That's a guaranteed kill on one of them. Let's take the one in the back. See, now, in this situation... It would be... Whoa, what's going on here? In that situation, it would be cool to have the mind control, because you could grab him, and then you could go fight the other one, and then just kill him off that way. But I do think that that protection rift thing is going to come in pretty handy at some point here. Now, we do have this guy over here that I'm a bit worried about, so I might run and gun over and take out that one instead, and then bring the mechs up to take care of this little sectoid back here. There he is. Let's be responsible with our ammo choices here. And use the pistol. Alright. Now. Can't get close enough for a punch, but this should do it. Come on now. Okay.
Erledigt.
Heading to that location.
Sectoids are down. I'm gonna dash Boom Boom up. Boom Boom might be kind of our last shot every time. Until we get into the heat of things, just so that I can dash her up knowing that there's safety, so we can have a rocket on the following turn. We'll see if I stick with that. Also, I've kind of learned a few things, basically from you guys, about how to use proximity mines in some different ways. So if I get the opportunity to do that, then I will. Basically, the idea is to toss out... So, a couple of things you could do. Whoa. Are you kidding me? Now, I don't think I have a good shot here. No, I don't. So the idea with the proximity mines is to put them down. You could use a shredder rocket on a guy first even, and then blow up the proximity mine with a grenade. That could come in really handy against those sectopods that we keep running into. I'm a bit worried that we're a little congested here. But I do kind of want to just draw these guys back and deal with them on an overwatch, I think. Or do I want to deal with them now? Does this risk, does this rift do anything against robotic enemies? Low will, doesn't say. Can we get up that high? No, we can't, okay. And I think we need a clear path too, so might be out of the question for right now. Let's bring them back here. Same with Gussie. We're gonna pull back on green here.
Okay.
And Raidry, I want you back as well. Over here might be okay. There we go. And we're gonna overwatch everybody.
I'll show.
Okay, I'm back. I don't know what happened, but I just minimized to the desktop. That happens to me in XCOM for some reason. I can't figure out why.
I'm watching for them.
Alright, let's see what happens here. One critical. I kind of don't want to waste all of my shots on these little guys. Like that.
Ah, damn it.
It's smart of them to do this, though.
Target disabled.
Oh god, this is gonna hurt. Here it comes. Miss!
Oh,
shit! And all our cover's gone too. Alright. Well, we took a little bit of damage. In hindsight, I probably should have just went at them. Where's Ragery so I can draw this Overwatch? Now we kind of need to take these things out.
In position. Contact.
Oh, shoot me. What the hell? That didn't work as planned. Well, let's take a couple of shots here. Walda. Hit one of them, I'll be happy.
Targeting malfunction.
Oh shit. Alright. I don't want to have to use rockets this early. That's kind of the problem here.
Gear in position.
Yeah, see. I wish I could have drawn that with Ragery, but... Alright. The same effect. Only 50% on these guys. Like, wow. Missed 3 50% in a row. Those odds. Well, I have to get into cover now. So... In hindsight, I really should have just done this in the first place. I don't have any good place to be, really.
I'm on the move.
But I need to be behind something. All right, let's go on it. There we go. Dealing out the heavy D. Got some squad site action here that we can use to maybe take that thing out. Come on now. Oh yes, that is beautiful. All right, now we can take a shot on this guy here. We'll try for a crit as well with the headshot. Oh my god, 19? That is crazy. Alright, now I'm pretty sure I feel like Annette can kill this thing. but from down here, I don't think we had vision, so I'm gonna have to maybe leave her in the open. Maybe I'll take cover here.
Are you sure it's safe?
There we go. Chances aren't great. I could just use a rift, maybe. I don't know if this thing's affected, that's the thing. Like, it doesn't look like it. Oh, there. Let's try this, see if it works on robotics.
It is.
Boom. It's got a 4-turn cooldown, which is okay, actually. That's not such a bad thing. Man.
Shoot! Miss the target!
This is the way our luck is gonna go here. We're gonna have some serious work to do. Here we go.
He's down.
Alright, Annette. See if you can get the other ones as well. And by Annette, I mean Boom Boom. So
no
sorry, Booms.
That is not good.
Okay.
Come on now. Finish him off. Jeez. We're not having luck against these flying guys.
Kind prefer.
Let's take 266s from here. Oh man.
I'm going to need ammo soon. Shot failed to connect.
Okay, well, this is good. This is really good. I know Raidry can probably do this.
Ich mach mich los.
Come on now. There we go. 280s. Good job. Now let's just dash up here. Let's reload Walda. We're gonna take a round to get everybody reloaded. I might heal up Annette here in the middle, or Boom Boom.
Okay, I'll check it out.
Let's do it. See, I think Bieber was healing for 10 because he was a colonel. And Annette's not quite there, but it's okay. We'll have to deal with what we have. Alright, let's get Gussie, like, way up here.
Location confirmed.
Alright. So they're talking about the, oh, damn it. Really? Okay, Boom Boom. Let's get into position here. Good night, Sectoid.
X-ray down.
Keep your head down. Beautiful. You want to get in here to kill this one? 85%. Come on. Man, Boom Boom is tearing it up right now. Let's reload. We can... Actually, we could probably kill this thing outright. 100% and 100 critical. Let's just do this. She'll have in the zone available.
Kill confirmed.
Now, did that find any more? It didn't. So I can still reload here now. And does anybody else need healing? I think we're going to be okay for healing right now. I don't have any full cover that I can run. Oh, yes, I do. Yes, I do. Let's do that.
I'm on my way. Overwatch, roger.
Annette, you might as well... Might as well.
Sure it's safe?
We'll reload you next turn, I guess. Because Boom Boom's a little bit out of position right now. So I would like to get her up here somewhere.
Location confirmed.
Hold on! I'm reloading!
Scanning.
Feldposten.
Roger that. Scanning.
I'm just doing this so that we can get Boom Boom a little bit closer to the action here. Let's see. All right, so now let's get Tufson up even further. Hello. Now, she could probably take those out on her own. If I'm being totally honest. Oh, Jesus. I didn't see these, though. And we got an elite over here. Can we take them out? Let's
position
see.
Position confirmed. Hostile unit located.
Now, do I go on the one over here, or do I go and take this one out with the guarantee. I might actually want to use someone else to do that. Let's see.
No need to ask twice.
Let's move Annette over. She doesn't have vision on any of them. Oh, that's interesting. Okay, what about Raidry? I could get her down here to take care of this one. I think I might do that. And then have everybody else in a position to shoot at him. And then Raidry's still in cover down there, so this should work out okay. It's 100%, so I don't need to. Yeah. 17 will do. Jesus. Now, though, I don't think I'm going to be able to see this guy. Nope, not from there. So let's actually take green down here. And hopefully. I can't believe that Duran cannot see this. I could rift again. You know what? Let's actually do this. We have it. We might as well use it. Oh, Jesus. I didn't really realize how much damage that uses. Okay, we're gonna take the shot here. If that doesn't work, we'll use a grenade. Come on, Walda. There we go. Now, typically, like, I don't want to use that rift on one guy, but
I've got my eyes on.
It'll definitely work. Don't get me wrong. Now, these guys, we're going to get in the zone, so I'm going to take the guy in the back out.
X-ray neutralized. Contact.
See where he goes. Oh, even better. ...96%. Yeah, let's go for it.
Target down.
Okay.
I hope you thought this through.
Area cleared.
I'm on the move.
Boom, boom, come all the way up.
Weapon systems ready. I'll shoot anything that moves.
And it's probably ideal that we reload every time. Because if we don't, we're going to end up in a situation where we're just going to be outnumbered. Like, things are going to get pretty nutty here pretty quickly. Oh, right. I forgot about my little chrysalid buddies. I'm not gonna lie, like, Gussie, I'm very happy that I brought you along. Like, so happy. I'm gonna see if you can take out all of these. Switch you over to your pistol. Oh my god, come on. Pretty close. Okay. Annette, you want a mind fray? It's only 50%, but let's go for it. Beautiful. Annette is literally just toying with everyone right now. Like, she has some serious power. I'm gonna dash Raidry up to get some vision of what's happening up here. Because there was a door here, but I'm not sure what the hell just happened to it. And then everybody in behind.
I'm on the move. I feel, Commander. Scanning.
Okay, okay, Duran, I'll come on up. Tufson, get in here.
Roger, Dodger.
Find out what's going on. Hello, thin men.
Our being of intelligence and exceptional loyalty, easily adapted to serve our needs. Still, despite such great hopes, they were unable to embrace the gift. Another wasted example.
Now, thin men, like, they have the aim of, like, our best snipers. They are incredibly hard to kill. And so when you first find them in the game, they are pretty scary. Like, they really, really are. How can I kill this guy? I guess coming over here with green is a pretty good option. Oh, damn it. Well, we have a pretty good chance on him down there, but so will other people. Let's see what we have available. Already moved Annette up a bit, so that's going to be out of... I don't think we'll have vision from here. I don't think we'll have vision from here either. Boom, boom. Can you see anything from in here? I guess not. So let's just grab full cover here. You'll be concealed, so it's not a big issue. And I think instead of just sitting out here, I am just going to take cover
from the thin man.
And I'm hesitant. I'm thinking maybe I should check here. I don't think I could see him from there.
On the move.
I'm going to go in. Give these guys the additional cover that they'll probably need from this guy up here. And I will take the 80% on the one below. That way we know there's only one.
Eliminated.
And I could use a grenade here, but I think I'm gonna hold off. Yeah, I'm gonna hold off. I'm okay with that. Because now we're gonna punch this guy out of this world. Goodbye. That's so satisfying. Now, I do have to consider the poison gas that's all around us. Do we have space on this side? Yeah, we do. Just have to make sure that our guys don't run through it. Okay, now Tufson, if I put you here, are you gonna dash through there? No, that's good.
Stepping off.
And last but not least, we'll put Raidry over here. I probably should have done this the other way, but either way will work. If I would have, I should have put Raidry into full cover against the door, is what I was trying to say. That's right, Annette has it too. So everybody has memetic skin. I didn't even realize that till right now.
Got it, moving.
A lot of people were telling me my memory's pretty poor. Yep. Yep. If you've been watching any of my videos for any period of time, it's something that I'm constantly working on. It's always been a bit of a problem for me. Alright, I'm gonna stack up on the door here. Mind you, do I want to do that? Because if I run through here...
We're green to go.
That is unfair, right? Okay, okay, I'm going. If they cross my path, they die.
Roger that. Scanning. I'm on my way.
Yeah, I think we'll do this. This is fine.
Scanning.
And then I'll run through there with Gussie. See if she finds anything. I do have a battle scanner as well, but I have to remember, why can't I get through here? Is it because Clank's in the way? Oh my god. I think it is because Clank's in the way. We're probably going to run into those Seekers at some point. And that's going to be interesting. But it's a reason that I might want to just, you know, hold on to the battle scanner. All right, let's grab this here. All right. Whoa. Okay.
And yet, they are incapable of brilliance, of independence. They will never be more than primitive warriors, serving only to fight and die, as did those who came before them.
All right, now we've got four mutons and one berserker. The berserker, I don't worry about these, because they're very, very... predictable. You can control them. The other ones, yeah, I do worry about. And if I can't kill them right now, I'm not sure that I want to run in there. Duran could probably get in here and rift one, but can I get into full cover? That's the question. I can over here. And then I could probably rift and get rid of a batch of them at least. Why don't I do that?
I understand.
So risky. Now, Ragery, I think same thing, but we'll put you somewhere else. Maybe down in front here. Let's do this. Boom, boom. I'm thinking the same thing. Is this full cover? Yes, that's beautiful.
Time to motor.
And then our big guys here. I should have been paying attention to where we set them off. If we pop our heads just inside here, is that going to be too far? Alright, sweet.
Moving out. Overwatch confirmed.
Alright. Now, we're in sound positions to deal with these guys. Definitely. So let's use our mind rift here. On these guys, for some reason it's blocked. There we go. I don't think I can... No, I can't quite reach that guy. Alright, take him out. Let's see if it sets off the berserker. Woohoo! Jesus! It didn't even set off the berserker. That is beautiful. Now, where is... Ragery. See, what I should have done is probably got her, like, right down here. Either way, this is still pretty good. I don't know why my chances to hit are so low. Alright, well, let's get Boom Boom. She's gonna get two shots, so she could even maybe kill both of these guys. Now that berserker is probably gonna... No, no. Interesting. Let's see if we can get this. That would be real nice. Ah, okay. It's too much to ask.
Target still up.
We do have a 90% shot over here, which would be real nice because we have in the zone. Up to 10 damage. Do I want to use the crit? No. Let's just go for it. Come on. Oh, that is freaking painful. That is super unfortunate. Okay, well, that changes things a little bit. I could probably kill this guy straight up. Maybe not. I might be a little overconfident there. But if we can't, I'm pretty sure someone else can. Missing that 90% shot was pretty painful.
Look out! Time to open.
No, where are you going? Oh my god, damn. Well, this will have to do. Holy wow. Okay, that'll do.
Ich rücke vor.
Come on now. Somebody just needs to hit. Yeah, that ain't gonna do it, is it?
Sie noch aktiv.
And where else am I gonna have a shot from? You know what I'm gonna do? I'm actually going to blow his cover. Force him to move. Ah, but that's gonna hurt her cover as well. I have no more shots, so I probably should have done that a different way. It's not gonna kill him anyways, so why waste it? That's how I'm looking at it. I'm gonna take the low percentage, you never know. Nah, ain't gonna happen. Alright. Let's see who he decides to target.
Shot failed to connect.
Perfect. Oh, Jesus, that's actually a lot more than I anticipated. Annette's gonna need to come over and heal, like, ASAP.
Got it, moving.
Let's use kinetic strike on this guy.
In Ordnung, Commander. Nähere mich für Angriff.
Oof. Alright. That restorative mist is looking really good right now.
Time to motor.
Whoa. Oh my god, that's two of them. So I'm running over here with Boom Boom so that maybe I can get down into full cover here on the next turn to be able to fire off a rocket.
Ready to engage hostile targets.
I'll reload first, and then we'll move in. Man, this is like, this is really intense right now.
You know more about this than I do.
I've got to heal him up a bit, and I might even need to use like two here. It's really too bad we don't have a colonel.
Munition.
Agreed to go. Moving to Overwatch.
And let's just reload. Let's use another one.
You're going to be all right.
Okay. Now, Boom Boom. What do you think? This looks good, hey? Oh, I think that might even look good. Actually, you know what? Let's get you here.
Location confirmed.
I'm worried about finding like four of them at once here. Two is already a big problem. But potentially, this is where some of these proximity mines could come in handy.
Moving out.
They're not moving, so
proximity mine in position.
I might do something crazy here. Where can I go that I could potentially get there next time without being seen? I'm gonna go here, which should keep me out of sight. We will just hunker down here. And just come over here with green. Okay, now Durand. Can I get you as far there? I can't quite. Next time I can.
I hope you thought this through.
Yeah, a little bit.
Look out!
We're just surrounding them right now. Like, that's all I'm trying to do. Just surround them.
No problem.
All right, I'm gonna toss another one down here.
Laying mines.
Oh, this is gonna be ridiculous. We're gonna see how this works. Okay, I think I'm gonna do one more mine. She's got five. Maybe I should just keep doing this.
Launching proximity mine.
If they're just gonna sit there.
I'm going.
Let's go grab full cover all the way down at the end. Just so we're fully aware of what we're dealing with here.
I'm on it. Overwatch. Aye, aye.
I just don't want any part of these things. So I'm gonna put another one down here even.
Confirmed mine placement.
I'll shoot anything that moves.
Alright, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna shred a rocket, and then I might just even mind rift them, and that might be enough. But we'll see. As long as we don't miss this, that would be bad. Hot. Ho-ho-ho-ho! That is so sick!
Lots of bad guys over here.
Oh god, that is awesome! That is so good. Come on now. Well, I found out my new sectoid killing strategy. Or, sectopod killing strategy. I'm gonna kill these guys with regular guns. Oh shit. What's this? What are these? Oh, are these Muton Elites? They sure are.
This will bring about our redemption and usher in our future.
Okay. Interesting. I don't know if I want to stay. I guess I could stay up here. Are these guys safe, though? That's kind of... I'm a little bit worried here. That they're just going to come over here and pummel Annette. I may want to dash here to give her some protection.
Ich gebe Gas.
In case they come too close. And I may even just overwatch here.
Roger that. Scanning.
See what happens.
I'm on the move.
Maybe we'll grab some lower ground here with the mechs. I probably didn't even need to shred her there because it was dealing out so. Whoa, what the hell? Oh, okay. That seems fair. Oh, God, that's good. Okay. Yeah, I probably didn't even need to shred her there just because I was dealing out so much damage with the mines anyway. Alright, now he's on Overwatch, which is cool. I'm okay with it. I just have to decide where I want to be here. We do have the rift, so we should be okay. Maybe I should rift first. See if we can just get rid of them. Because if I'm... Yeah, it can hurt us too, so... Oh my god, that's so good. It is so good. Now, can I go in here? Or will I get hurt? Like, it's not hurting him now, so I don't see why I couldn't go in. Oh, it does hurt! Oh my god, that's not good. That is really actually quite terrible. I did not know that. That's really bad. Okay. So I've got... I've got like one med kit left. That's not good.
On the move.
That's super unfortunate. I guess that's how you learn. Damn it. Okay. What? Oh my god. Jesus. Okay, well, let's revive.
You're ready to fight.
That is crazy. I'll never make that mistake again. I'll tell you that much.
Heading to that location.
On the move.
Man, that's freaking scary.
Running.
That could have went way worse. It's already pretty bad. Okay, Gussie, I'm gonna need you to get in there.
Location confirmed.
See what we're dealing with here.
Okay, moving out.
Ich bin schon auf dem Weg.
Heading there now.
I'm on the move. Ich mach mich los.
Overwatch confirmed.
I'm reloading my gun.
Auf Feldposten.
Feldposten, moving to Overwatch.
These Overwatches probably aren't really necessary, but just in case. All right. Let's see. Let's grab this corner.
Looks like ET phoned home for some
reinforcements. Oh, we're at the end of the ship.
Behold the greatest failure of the Imperial ones. Will you fail to ascend as they thought we would?
Okay, so I don't know if things have changed since Enemy Unknown, but from what I remember, if we kill just the main one there, if we kill this one, then that kills everything else. So that's going to be my goal. But I need to try and get full cover here with these guys, which, oh, hello, there's a little bit there. But I think that's gonna be about it. Unless we go down here, which I can totally do. This would actually work out pretty good. And I can rift in two turns. That's huge. Let's actually
yes,
do
Commando.
That. Now, oh, Raidry, oh my god. I know you're probably just like, nope, not a chance of me going in there. But, you're gonna kinda have to.
In Ordnung, Commander.
We don't really have the range. I don't know if we have the range to get these guys down there.
Aye, aye, Commander.
We'll have to see if we can get there next turn.
Moving to Overwatch.
We do have our full rocket blast as well.
The hunt draws to a close. It was not a vain undertaking, but a necessity. As our physical form has grown ineffective, our search for the perfect specimen was driven by our own crippling limitation. And now, at long.
See, that would be a perfect rift because they're all in there. Oh, this looks pretty nice too, though. If I go here, though, I don't have a great rocket shot. But actually, because of the fusion, we do actually. So let's do this. I'll have to make sure not to overwatch. Let's just head up a bit. We can overwatch here.
Schon unterwegs.
Heading to that location. Scanning.
Now I don't want these guys to overwatch though, because I want to be. Yeah, I shouldn't even overwatch back there, but I want to be in control of what happens here, so. We'll see what they decide to do. I imagine these big guys will just overwatch again. Where did the main one go? Oh, they're not overwatching. There we go. Damn it. Where is the big one? Oh, I lost track of them. That's bad news. All right, I'm gonna switch to my alloy cannon, and I'm gonna get close there. We might get the close quarters shot to happen. But we need to, he's right there. Okay. So let's see here. Do we wanna make this happen now, or wait one turn? I think we're gonna wait one turn.
I'm watching.
I don't even want these guys up front to be overwatched either. I don't know if I should come in here yet. Let's take a look. Okay. Let's hunker down. And I kind of just want him to not do anything, but I don't really have that choice. I could just move, I guess. Let's just move back.
Commander.
See, I don't know why we can't see him right now. Yeah, everybody group up right about there. That would be ideal for me. And, oh, this is perfect, because he was the last one to move. So now they're all going to panic. Whoa! Okay, so he could see him. All right, there's our target. Let's rocket him. Can I get this one up here? No, but I can get these three.
Firing rocket.
Woo-hoo! Wow. Okay, now we're gonna rift. Okay, but oh right, these things with the high will, they block this a little bit better than others. So I may want to do this a bit differently. I'm worried about them reflecting the attack too. That's a big concern. Oh man.
Ich rücke vor.
Who's on Overwatch? All right. Oh my god. Like, we're here. Let's not blow it. Let's use grenades. We can get all three of these guys in here. Walda, guess what? You're going to be doing the exact same thing, except I don't know if you're going to be able to reach. What I should have done, launch that damn proximity mine again and blew it up. That's what I should have done. Do I have rockets or any explosives with anybody else here? No, I don't. I have a mimic beacon. I don't know if the rift would blow that up. I'm probably gonna rift anyways, even if the chance is low. Do I wanna just take the guaranteed 5? I think I do. Yeah, let's do it. And now, the other question that I have to think about is, if I do rift, then I can't run in there with Rage Reeks. It'll kill her. Like last time. So let's just see if we can just do this. Right here, right now, Gussie. Right here, right now. Alright, fine. Not right here.
Shot failed to connect.
Oh man. Okay, Raidry. This is your moment.
Bring sie zur Strecke. Ich zisch ab. Feind in Sicht.
Come on. There it is. Take them all with you. So, okay.
Is behaving like a dying star, becoming a black hole. At this distance, the Earth will be consumed.
Central, I'm bugging out. The package is not on board.
Waited as long as I could, sir.
Sir, the alien ship is in motion.
What direction? What direction?
Up.
Our finest hour. New custom gameplay options are now available for enemy within. Select second wave. So that brings up a really good point. I probably am going to do another playthrough of this with some second wave options right away. And for people wondering about the roleplay season, there will be a video coming up very soon with some new information regarding that. It is happening, and there are going to be some guidelines in place. And get your writing brains on, because there's going to be, instead of just first come, first serve, like it has been, we're going to do kind of a, we're going to look at like the top quality submissions, because it's getting to a point where there's a lot of interest, and the first come, first serve, it works for the people that are quick, but certain time zones can't participate, and oftentimes the people that are really quick to get in there don't participate as much, and there's a lot of reasons to do it a little bit differently, but stay tuned for that video. Let's check out some of our stats here. So, overall score, 112. I don't know what this is. I don't know if these are, like, glitches or what. But this, the world's like a million. I think this is, like, the average. Days until victory, pretty bang on. Battles won, pretty bang on. Oh, this is restricted to impossible. Okay. Battles lost, 0.25. This is, like, strikingly similar. I did lose a lot more soldiers than the rest of the world. Funding countries quite a bit. Countries lost 2. Days until the base cleared. Days until ethereal device recovered. Days until psionic soldier discovered. That's cool. Battles fought. Look at how like bang on these are. All these averages. That's crazy. Average shot percentage, 70. Average damage per shot is actually quite a bit lower. Number of turns per battle. Yeah, this makes sense because I'm pretty cautious. One shot kills. This is cool. I like looking at this stuff. Soldiers hired 2. Did I only hire 2 soldiers? That doesn't make sense. Does it? Maybe I did. I didn't have a lot die. OTS upgrades. Days until first colonel. Infirmary. Jesus. Walda took up like 75% of that. Days until firestorm. A little bit late. All right. Like, look at this. That's something screwed there, I'm sure. Same thing with engineers. Total credits earned, spent, Illyrium, funding countries. Cool. Okay, well, that was awesome. I just want to say thank you guys for the support in this series. It's been a freaking blast. I was in touch, speaking of Ananda Gupta here, I was in touch with Ananda Gupta over Twitter regarding this. And I talked to him about making the We Survive Newfoundland t-shirt. I thought that would be really cool. I might even create that if I can. I don't know what the logistics are behind that, but really cool. I kind of wish the ending was changed a little bit with the Enemy Within add-on, but you know what? So many things were different where it was like, I didn't care about the cinematics as much. Like, it was just so cool. All the new stuff. There's a lot that I learned. There's a lot I want to implement in my next playthrough based on feedback from you guys. So I thought there was a lot to be learned and a lot of new things to be done. What I am going to do here, just really quickly, if you guys are still watching, I know it's like over an hour in here, but I just want to take a look at some of the second wave options. So this will probably be the setup that I start a new game on. Just like this, but second wave. So we've got a ton of stuff in here. So I'm gonna kind of go through some of them and then tell you what my thoughts are on them. So damage roulette, I've played with this before. It seems like it only tends to impact you negatively. Like if you have a shot that can do up to 10, then your range is kind of like 5 to 10. You know, very rarely do you see it go over that. I don't know if I like that option. Yes, it makes it harder, but I also like, if I'm going to take a 70% shot, I'd like that shot to at least do the damage that it's expected if I hit. So I don't know if I'll do that. This I'll probably do. So the funding offered by individual council members is randomized. So I think that's really great because it brings like fresh. You don't always want to just go straight for North America or, sorry, United States because they have the most money, things like that. Not created equally, I like this. Rookies will have random starting stats. I just think more randomness, the better. Is with things like that, anyways. Hidden potential. I kind of like this as well. Their stats increase randomly. I do think that makes your soldiers maybe a little bit overpowered, so I'd like to hear some thoughts on that. Training roulette. Each soldier's training tree will be mostly random generated. Does not apply to mech troopers. So what this means is, like, you could have up close and personal on a sniper, like, if that was the option. I don't know if I want to do that. That seems, like, pretty nutty. Save scum. Loading a save game will reset the random number seed. That doesn't really apply because on Iron Man you can't load saves. Any wounds taken in combat will degrade a soldier's stats for that mission. I kind of like that, but it's scary as hell. That's a maybe. Absolutely critical. A flanking shot will guarantee a critical hit. Now, this sounds like, yeah, well, that sounds really cool. Except that if you get flanked, it goes against you too. So, I don't know. It does kind of make sense, because if you're flanking somebody, it's like, well, you know, you're going to shoot them. They're unexpected. So, it probably would be a critical hit. I'm just thinking, like, if I was, like, flanking somebody. So maybe. The greater good. The secret of psionics can only be learned by interrogating a psionic alien. I like that. That's how we got it. So, I mean, we could probably take that. Instead of learning it from, what is it? You have to, like, assault. I can't remember the... There's a couple things that let you get it, but I might take that. The game takes considerably longer to complete. Somebody suggested that I do the marathon run, not just for, like, a second wave playthrough, but also for the role play, so that people have more of a chance of getting in, because there's more of a chance of people dying and all that kind of stuff. So, I don't know, though. Like, I think XCOM's a pretty good length. If you go into this, you just kind of start to feel like you're farming, and the missions become really repetitive, I would think. A country will offer less funding as its panic increases. That's super scary, but might be a good option. High stakes, the rewards grant for stopping alien abductions are randomized. Oh. So does that mean that you wouldn't get the option to, like... So if you pick three places, it's not going to tell you what you get, or it's just going to be completely random. Like, you might get 3 engineers, you might get 100 credits, or... I'm not sure how that works, so that's a maybe. The cost of satellites increases with everyone that's built. I don't like that, but it would make things considerably more difficult. I don't know. I tend to like putting up satellites really early and often, because I think I like taking the risks on the battlefield more than I like taking them in the base. Psionic gifts is extremely rare. Well, it's already pretty rare, so I don't know about that. Upon being revealed, some aliens may attempt to shoot at soldiers instead of moving or going to Overwatch. Yeah, see, that's ballsy. That is really interesting. That could be a fun one to try, because you'd really have to make use of your battle scanners and your memetic skin. Might be worth it. Overall funding levels drop inexorably with every month that passes. Maybe. Illyrium stores degrade over time. Sorry, we just cut out there. My XCOM minimized again. I don't know why that happens. It's driving me bonkers. I don't know if I would do that one or the Illyrium, because... Well, I don't... We could maybe just throw the Illyrium on there, I guess. It's like use it or lose it type of thing. Lose all gear from soldiers who die in combat. I kind of like this one. I do kind of like that, because it's like... Some stuff, like when you get those heavy weapons, man, that stuff's expensive. And you lose that, it's pretty bad. Power requirements of all facilities are increased. I don't know if that's really necessary. I do kind of want to try this. Units receive an aim bonus the closer they are to flanking an enemy. And that goes for the enemy as well against you. So I'd probably try that. Genetically modified soldiers cannot undergo psi training or psi testing. Gifted soldiers can never receive genetic mods. Ooh. That's cool. So it's either like you either go psionics or you go meld. That is really interesting. That would kind of be cool to try, I think. I think so. So yeah, I'm thinking that this is probably a preview of what I might do. I'm hesitant on training roulette, but it could be just really bizarre to see some really interesting builds. Red fog I might turn on, so if somebody gets hit, they're going to do worse. Flank, I might turn on absolutely critical, and have to remember that goes against me as well. Secret of psionics, I'll probably turn on. Marathon, I don't know. and I doubt I'll do results driven, but I'm open for debate on a lot of these. So if you guys have some opinions, I would love to hear them. But probably within a day or two of this video going up, I will start a second wave playthrough. And then I'll have another separate video with information on the roleplay that will be a completely separate series from my second wave playthrough, so that we can really put some time into the roleplay. I have some more ideas that we're going to incorporate that's going to make that a really cool experience. So thanks guys so much for watching. Seriously, all the support in this series has been like overwhelmingly cool. And I've learned a lot from your comments. I don't get a chance to reply to every comment, but I certainly try to read as many as I can. And there's some people that know a lot about XCOM and have some really strategic minds. And I love learning from you guys like that. So thanks again. I had a ton of fun with this. I hope you guys did too. And we'll see you next time. Bye.